Praise the Lord. It's another beautiful day. Wake up, and let's pray. This is MFC 365. This is our mercy and favor challenge. This is where we engage in the place of prayer. I tell you, it's a good thing to pray. Hallelujah. When we pray, there is a God that has promised to answer our prayers. And hear me, prayers does wonders. Today is day 114. And today is the 24th of April. Our prayer focus is an interesting one today, and it is sink down walls of terrible. Hallelujah. In this segment of prayers, we are thanking God. I love to thank God. And of course, it's a good thing to give thanks to the Lord. And that is why we are spending time praying and giving thanks to God. Bible says in the book of Philippians chapter 2, from verse 9 to 10, therefore God has also highly exalted him and given him a name that is above every name, and that at the name of Jesus every knee will bow and every tongue in heaven that will confess that Jesus is Lord. Go ahead, begin to give thanks to the Lord.
Era la banana,
In this segment, go ahead and intercede for our nation. I'm praying for Nigeria, and we will be praying for our local assembly. I am praying for Shouts of Grace Center. I'm praying that the Lord will cause every walls of Jericho, every walls of stagnation to sink in the name of Jesus. Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 16 and verse 18, the NLT, it says, "Now I say to you that you are Peter," which means rock. "On this rock build my church, and all the powers of hell will not conquer it." In the name of Jesus, go ahead.
Era la banda de la
Here we are praying for our pastors, our parents, and our mentors. We are going to lift them up before God in prayers. It's good to pray for our pastors, our parents, and our mentors, because they are those who speak into our lives and have authority over our lives. The Bible says in Psalm 18 and verse 29, it says, "For by thee I have gone through the truth, and by my God have I lived over a wall." Oh, can back at I am. Asking that God will strengthen our parents and our pastors.
Shalom,
In the segment of prayers, we are lifting up our financial life before God. We are asking that God will strengthen our finances. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 60 and verse 5, it says, "And then you shall see and become radiant, and your heart will swell with joy, because the abundance of the sea shall return to you, the wealth of the nations shall come to thee." Go ahead and begin to pray. Every Bushia, El Akataya, Bubaya, Dadaba, Busha Kataya Baba, O Bede Keteleba, the abundance of the sea shall become abundant to us. In the name of
Shalom,
Go ahead and begin to pray for your family. If you are the wife, you may need to pray for your husband and your children. If you are the husband, pray for your husband, your wife and your children. If you are not married, pray for your friends and your fiance. Go ahead and pray. Every war of Jericho, every war that is standing as an opposition will fall down. Every one who sings in the name of Jesus, Bible says in Psalm 5 and verse 1, those who trust in the Lord and I will from Zion, they are not defeated, but they will endure forever. Go on and pray, your marriage, your family, your hope will endure.
Shalom,
The secret, we are making warfare in the name of Jesus. We are able says in the book of Joshua chapter 6 and verse 20, the Amplified Version says, so the people shouted and the trumpets were blown. When the people heard the sound of the trumpet, they raised a great shout and Jericho's wall fell down in its place so that the Israelites went into the city, every man straight before him. The city will be the God. After Masha Kataya, we are making warfare in the segment. We are taking the city, we are taking what belongs to us, we are taking the Jew, we are taking.
Shalom,
Presenting it before God, that every sinful sing in the name of Jesus. But it says in the book of Revelation, chapter 3, and verse 7 in the message translation, it says, write this to Philadelphia, to the angel of the church, the holy, the truth, with his key in his hands, opening doors no one can go, knocking doors no one can go, speak. In this segment, you pray and declare it on some night to more blissful book, and you are putting the words of the psalm into your mouth from beginning to the end. No evil shall be for you, neither shall any plague come nigh your dwelling. The Bible says in Psalm 91 and verse 7 of the Message translation, even though others support all around them, drop like flies right at them, we will come, we ever praise you. Hallelujah. We are going to be praying this prayer. Oh, Shakata, you can be the Ophosi Kataya, but no evil before you. In the name of Jesus, you will be accepted. You make it the blood declaration. you are declaring what the blood of Jesus is for you. Ah, you are declaring and confessing what you have through the blood of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 3 and verse 28 in the New Living Translation, it says, for God presented to Jesus as a sacrifice for sin. People are made right with God when they believe that Jesus sacrificed his life, shedding his blood, the sacrifice shows that God was not far when he held back and did not punish those who sinned. In this segment, you are praying the Pauline prayers. You are praying the same prayers Apostle Paul prayed for the early church, and you are lifting up your voice and asking for wisdom in the name of Jesus. Bible says in the book of Proverbs, chapter 15 and verse 13, in the Message translation, it reads, "Oh, may God of clean hope fill you with joy, fill you up with peace, so that your believing lives fill with the life-giving energy the Holy Spirit will bring over with hope. Go ahead and see. Pray for yourself. Pray for your pastors.
Pray for your loved ones.
In the segment, you are lifting up your voice and you are praying for it. Alaboshi Epeti Kepusu Kataya Baba, Alabaya Kataya. You are interceding that God will grant you healing in the name of Jesus. I'm joining my faith. Everyone that is sick, I'm believing God for healing. I will say it in the book of James, chapter 5, verse 14 and 15. It reads, anyone among you sick, let him call for the leaders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith will save him that will see that the Lord will raise him up from raising up. And if he has committed any sin, In this segment, lifting up your voice and you are praying with everything that you have, that God will grant you favor, God will grant you mercy in every area, in the name of Jesus. If you have a project before you, this is the time to pray that favor will attend to you. The Bible says in Psalm 23, verse 6 in the Amplified, surely only goodness, mercy, and unfailing love shall follow you in the days of your life and throughout the length of your days in the house of the Lord, and this presence shall be given. Go ahead and see, and people shall enter. You have favor, you have mercy, in We will be made of God. We have come to the end of today's prayers, and we are sure, we know of the surety that God has answered our prayers. Let's go ahead and begin to give Him thanks and give Him all the glory and appreciate Him, because we have a God that answers prayers. Hallelujah. Yes, we give Him thanks. This is the assurance we have. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare into our lives that every wall that is keeping us down, that is keeping us small, is eradicated in the name of Jesus. We enter into our inheritance, we enter into the greatness in the name of Jesus. Thank you for joining it today's prayers. I'll expect to see you at the same time tomorrow at 12 a.m.